I'm Brook Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. I'm here at the Hawaii Okinawa Center in Waipio with Gwen Fujie, who is the president, current president of Hui O Laulima. Hi, Gwen.
Well, hi, Brooke. Welcome to our center.
I've never been here before. This is so exciting. It's so beautiful.
It is a beautiful building. Thank you for having us on Modern Wahine.
You know, the Okinawan Festival is near and dear to Hawaii's heart, pandemic or no pandemic. So, you know, we were excited that we were able to come out and highlight and talk about all the wonderful things you guys have been doing over the years. But can you explain to people what the Hawaii Okinawa Association is?
The Hawaii United Okinawa Association. Yes, it started in 1951 with a group of businessmen and community leaders of Okinawan ancestry. They were the ones that helped to help the people of Okinawa after the Battle of Okinawa, when it was just totally devastated, to revive and to come alive again. And so they got together, they bought pigs and goats and chickens and sent all of that, as well as goods that I remember as a young girl, putting boxes of clothing together to get sent to Okinawa. So after they started to build up Okinawa, they got to be fine and everything was good, our men, who had really gained tremendous reputation and friendships and relationships with Okinawan people, decided to keep it going. And even among themselves. And so by 1951, they formed this United Okinawa Association. We are 50 clubs under the umbrella of HUOA.
Ah.
And those 50 clubs make up about 40,000 Okinawan members, but not only Okinawans, it's Okinawan wannabes,
right.
We say, Okinawan at heart people. Anyhow, we've been around for 70 years. This is our 70th anniversary as HUOA.
That's amazing. And so Hui O Laulima, which is the club you're the president of,
Yes. What
is it that Hui O Laulima does?
Yes, Hui O Laulima was formed by some of the leaders of the Okinawa Association. The men felt they needed some help with greeting and hosting visitors from Okinawa. And so the officers asked their wives. And so those are the women whose shoulders we stand on. Women like Jane Sakima, who was the wife of Akira Sakima, who's quite well known. Irene Kanetake, Lorraine Toma, all of those great women came together. 15 of them met in the Flamingo Chuck Wagon and formed their club in 1968. So from that time, it went from 15 to 305 members that we have now. They're not all Okinawans. There are a lot of women who are part Okinawan or not at all by blood, but they love the culture. And they are community service oriented. They like the festival. So we do a lot of different things for HUOA and for ourselves.
And so when you're talking, of course, about the festival and how important it is to remind people of the culture that comes from Okinawa and how significant and special it is, what do you think it is about this special group of women that keeps you guys in such a tight-knit hui and able to perpetuate all of these traditions?
Well, simple answer is, we like to have fun. I really believe if you're not having fun, people don't hang around. And we keep growing because we have fun. We have a purpose, and our purpose, like all the other clubs, is to perpetuate, to promote, and to preserve our Okinawan heritage and culture. So we're all into that, regardless of whether you have Okinawan blood or not. And also, I think we have a lot of pride. You know, our ancestors went through a lot. The first generation really worked hard to give us what we have today. And so I believe all 50 clubs are in that mode of deep gratitude. And that gratitude comes really from the heart, the spirit, the soul. And we continue on in that manner. I think the women are so laid back, and we have so much fun together that all of our projects, we have more than enough volunteers. It's really a wonderful organization.
What is the one thing that is your favorite thing that you do at the Okinawan Festival every year? Like, if someone has never been before and they go, what is the one thing you tell them that they should do?
The food booths are fabulous. A lot of people come who aren't Okinawan, and they come with their coolers to pick up undagi, to pick up underdog. They have so many special foods that they love and get to have only once a year. And so for me, our organization handles the cultural tent, is what we call it. And from the time that we moved to the Hawaii Convention Center, 2 years we've been there, we've had a huge room full of information about our culture. And Tina later on will be talking about that Bunkwa Nushima. But that is my favorite, because I myself learn a lot. And that's another thing why I think we stay together. We learn from each other. We have women from 20 years old up to 90 something years old. And, you know, we can learn from each other. I hang out with the young girls so that I feel younger and hang out with the older ones because I learn so much. And that's what keeps us going, I think, all of these over 50 years.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the show and sharing all of that wonderful information. As the president of Hui O Laulima, that's a really big responsibility, especially in the midst of a pandemic.
Yes.
And having to steer that ship through, you know, unknown waters. So we wish you all the best with the virtual Okinawa Festival this year. I'm sure it's going to be amazing, and people can just smell the undagi through the screen and scratch and sniff, I guess. But thank you so much for coming on the show today.
Well, we appreciate that. Thank you very much for having us.
Thanks. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Minsode! Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii. I'm here with Jeannie Yamasato, past president of Hui O Laulima, two-time past president.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Thank you for dressing me in this wonderful outfit.
Oh, yes, you look beautiful.
Thank you. I've never worn one of these before. Mm-hmm. So let's talk about how long you've been associated with the festival and with the organization.
Well, with the festival, I guess, goes quite far back, you know. I guess when it was at McCoy Pavilion and Thomas Square and Kapi'olani Park, all those years. Uh-huh.
And then when you're talking about what's popular at the festival every year, the kimono booth is like, yes. I mean, it's a headliner. Everybody comes every year. And they want to take pictures with the grandkids, and, you know, it's a tradition. Can you explain to people what that whole process is?
Yes, you know, it is popular, and we encourage them to come early because there's a whole line of people who wait. But if they put their names down, then we call them, because we do about 90 a day, I think.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so people come in their street clothes, obviously, and
yes.
then you guys put them in the traditional outfit.
Yes.
And then they pay for photo packages. Is that
yes.
what it is?
Uh-huh.
And then they get to take pictures. What do you think is the draw? Why do people want to come and be photographed in the traditional Okinawan attire?
Well, because you can't do this anywhere else. Our club and the Okinawan Association owns most of these, you know, kimonos and equipment, so, and it's a professional photographer. So families like to take, you know, their whole family picture.
Right.
Men and women. We have two kinds of costumes. The women wear the bingata, which is what you're wearing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's actually clothing for royalty.
Oh.
It's silk, and they're the only ones there. Either the royalty or performers. So it's very special. So even if you lived in Okinawa, unless you're a dancer, you probably wouldn't wear one of these.
Wear this to go to the shop.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, and we do it right, you know, over your daily clothes.
Right.
So it's very convenient. And then we also have a men's costume, which is the Asa costume. It started off as a bong, you know, like bong odori. type dance in the villages, but it's so popular, you know, so entertaining that it's become entertainment. You see it on stages and programs, and we have clubs. And so one of the active clubs here helped us with that costume. So it's a boy's costume with the vest and purple headgear and white pants. So, and that too will dress you over your clothes, whatever you come in.
And so how many costumes do you guys think you have currently?
Oh, gee, at least. But we have, for the boys, we have to have all the different sizes, like eight, 10.
For the kids.
Yeah, and adults. For the girls, it's not too bad, just toddlers and maybe teens and adults. So not too bad, but gee, I would say at least 3 dozen.
Wow.
Yeah.
So we're here in this beautiful garden, and you have a little bit of a special connection to the garden, don't you?
Oh, yes, I do.
What's your connection to this beautiful landscape?
Well, I start with my husband designed the Okinawa Center and the building across, and he talked his good friends, Koichi Takakura, into donating money for this empty spot here that it would make a beautiful garden. And so he said, oh, good idea. And he hired us a special Okinawan landscaper and who did research.
Uh-huh.
And he found all of this. And of course, the garden turned out bigger than
planned.
Yeah.
It's beautiful, though.
The volunteers really do a good job.
So beautiful. So we're going to talk about what I'm wearing, because you dressed me in this beautiful kimono. So where should we start? Should we start with the hat? Because you can't miss it.
Uh-huh, that's right.
What's going on with the hat?
Okay, most people recognize that hat.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, it's used during festive occasions. It symbolizes a flower. We call it hanagasa, which is flower hat. And the flower is supposed to be a peony.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. And it's made of silk with bamboo frame. And then the kimono you're wearing, like I said, is for royalty.
Silk.
Mm-hmm. And it's hand designed. And,
okay.
And usually it's of nature, you know, plants, flowers, animals.
And is the colors significant?
Yes, the colors, well, the gold is real typical. We use, and the red underneath, we use a lot of Chinese influence. So you see a lot of red and blue and gold, very Chinese.
Got it.
They used to send ambassadors to China. So you're wearing that, and you're wearing, inside is a dujing, which is a red top, and kakang, which is the white skirt. And there are times when they use just that for every day.
Oh, got it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's awesome. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show and explaining all of these wonderful things and putting me in this cultural extravaganza. It feels so wonderful to be Okinawan. Thank you. It's kind of like wearing a Miss Universe hat, but like lighter. Way lighter than the crown. Way lighter. But thanks so much for coming on the show.
Oh, thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii. I'm here at the Hawaii Okinawa Center with Tina Kaneshiro, past president, Hui O Laulima. Hi, Tina.
Hi, Brooke. Mensore.
Mensore. So let's talk about your esteemed volunteer career here with Okinawa Association. How long have you been volunteering now?
Well, with the Okinawa organization since 1985.
Okay. So that's a lot of andagi.
Yes.
A lot of festivals.
Yes,
a lot of festivals.
Yes.
And what do you guys, what does Hui O Laulima do without a pandemic in the mix? What do you guys do normally at the festival?
I would like to walk you through our Bunkwa Nushima.
Oh, okay.
And it's it's a cultural village. Brooke, you would be so happy. You came and stopped by the Hui O Laulima room. You walk in, we're at the door, we greet you, Mensore. So you walk in this Bunkwa Nushima, you come to the Shima Kutubar language exhibit, and we greet you with Ori Tori, Yayama way of saying welcome. Then in the middle of this room is a huge exhibit. We have a theme every year. So 2019, the theme was Hajichi, which is tattoo. And we have a big display. The women do the research, and we have pictures showing all those Okinawan ladies with their tattoos. Oh, yeah. What an exciting way to learn about that culture. Then we move along, we have a tattoo parlor.
Oh, wow.
Where you get to go and learn, do your own. And then moving on, we have Okinawan crafts. And there the children can make things to go.
Right.
They make hachimaki, that's the headband. And they can do a hanagasa charm to go.
Oh, wow.
And
nice.
They can show mom, you know, hey, look what I did.
Right.
Then we go over and we come to the display that features what our children learn here during the summer. And it's called the Okinawan Children's Camp. And at the children's camp, the children learn, which is done here at the Okinawa Center, they learn the history, they learn music, they learn the dance, they learn food, they do crafts, and they do games. And this they learn during the summer, and when they go home, they share with their parents.
Right.
And it's quite interesting because the parents said, I didn't know that. But we have a lot of Hui O Laulima ladies that volunteer during that camp. Then we move along and we come to Jeannie Yamasato's kimono dressing
area. Right, which
area.
We did earlier.
And you know, when you see those prints, you know it's Okinawan. How do you like the hanagasa?
Oh, I'm telling you, if I could dress like that every day, I would.
Just wait, I think you will. So along we go with, that's the busiest place to be, the kimono dressing. Then we move over. Have you seen our culture cookbook?
No, but I've heard wonderful things. It's very famous, the cookbook.
It's a beautiful cultural cookbook. It's not only about food and how to cook or prepare the food, but they also share the history. Uh-huh. And in that book, they have hajichi.
Oh, you the know, tattooing.
The tattooing. And one of our ladies sells the aprons, or several of them. And people, we encourage them to look through the book, the culture cookbook, and see, you know, if this would be a good omiyage to present to family members or friends. They can learn about Okinawan cooking, they can learn about our history, everything. So you say, yes, I want the apron too. So we put the book in the apron. The ladies have a certain way of wrapping it.
Right.
It's so adorable, and you're so happy. Then you go to the next exhibit. It's calligraphy.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
there's
yes.
There's a lot going
Can
on.
Can you see Brook Lee
in beautiful
yes,
calligraphy?
Yes. And you take it home and you hang it up on the wall. How beautiful is that? Then after you're done with that, we move you over to the Japanese Cultural Center. There you have hands-on again, and then you can have a fan, and that fan you featured the character of the year, dog,
right,
you know, whatever.
Right.
And you walk out of there. Then the last exhibit you see is University of Hawaii Okinawan Studies Department. So if you want to learn Uchinaguchi, you can ask them questions. You want to learn something about Okinawa, they should be able to answer your questions. But when you come towards our door to exit the room, our Bunkwa Nushima, we say, Brooke, thank you so much for coming today. Ipe nife debiru. And we bow to you, we thank you in gentleness. And you say, I had such a lovely time. And you say, Brooke, come back next year.
That's a lot going on at the village.
Oh, yes.
And so, since we're in pandemics and it's going to be virtual this year, you'll be taking them through all of the village online with someone with a camera?
Well, we do have a video that already features the Bunkwan no Shima, and it's very well done. So what I gave you was just a briefing of what you go through as you come in the room.
Right. That's amazing, though. I mean, there's so much culture and history to learn. I'm learning so much about the fact that Okinawa, they said, is just like Hawaii in a lot of ways.
Of course.
It's its own little island. It's part of the United States, just like Okinawa is part of Japan.
Mm-hmm.
But it's separate in its own little, you know, world. So
exactly.
We have a lot of connections between Hawaii and Okinawa.
Yes, yes.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the show and taking me through the village. It was amazing.
Of course, Brooke. You are always welcome to join us. And we say mensore.
Mensore. How do we say thank you?
Ipe nihe debiru.
Ipe nihe
debiru.
Debiru.
Correct.
Thanks
Good
for
job.
Coming on the show. This has been fun. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Well, that's our show for today, Hawaii. I hope you learned as much about the Okinawan culture as I have. I'm practically Okinawan, or at least an Okinawan wannabe, as they like to say, in my wonderful regalia. Don't forget, the festival is virtual this year, so you can go to okinawanfestival.com to check it out, or you can catch the highlights right here on KHON2. Mahalo to everybody here at HOC, Hawaii Okinawan Center, to Gwen Fujie and Jeannie Yamasato, and my good friend Tina Kaneshiro for making me look so fly in my outfit. Remember, we're coming to the end of the pandemic, but we do still need to socially distance. Wear your mask if you can, because you know, it's getting a little squirrely out there, Hawaii. Keep your distance from each other, wash your hands, and if you ever get a chance in the days past pandemic and you can wear this outfit, I highly suggest you wear the hat. It's much better than the Miss Universe crown. So don't forget, socially distance, the hat helps, and I will see all of you next week.